Hi guys, and welcome to another China unboxing video. In this video, we are going to have a first look at the stylish 5.5 inch Qbot X15 in white. In the past, I have also reviewed the X10 and X11 from Qbot. These can of course also still be found on my channel. And the Qbot phones have always been very stylish and in a good quality. So I'm of course very curious about the new X15. From the pictures I have seen on the net, it seems to have a very cool looking design and some pretty good specifications. And on the Qbot X15 we do also find a real CNC metal frame. It has a full HD IPS new LCD display with 2.5D glass and a very thin design on only 6.9mm. Let's unbox. So we have the box, we see the Qbot logo and we find the IMEI numbers in the bottom, Qbot and the CE logo. This one is the X15. Nice. On the back side we have the specifications. We have the website to Qbot, a CE logo. We see it's a 5.5 inch full HD using the MTK6735 quad core clocked at 1.3 GHz. You see the frequency supported, internal and external memory and the camera. So let's open up. Let's have a look inside. First of all the phone. Let me put this aside and let's see what we else have inside the box. We have some instructions how to insert the SIM cards. We find a small pin to open up the SIM tray. We have a screen protector. I believe there is already one attached to the phone also. We have a quick start guide in English and other languages. We find a standard micro USB cable, Qbot. And last we find the wall charger. Let's see, again branded Qbot with a CE logo. And this one here is a 5 volt 1 amp, so not a quick charger, standard charger. That's it. Inside here we also see information about where the front camera headphone jack is located, the buttons. We also see in the bottom of the screen there's a menu, home and back key, capacitive buttons. So now to the phone. Again we have some plastic, the IMEI numbers on the back side. Let me just remove this. And the phone here is right now in a case, some kind of clear case. And right now on the phone there is also a screen protector. I will see if I can show you it here. There's a small edge around actually in the sides and in the top and bottom, because the phone has what they call 2.5D arc screen. So it means that it's a little bit curved in the edge. The screen protector will only go 3mm to the edge. And here you can see the capacitive buttons. We have menu, home and back. Actually they are located in the black frame, so that's pretty smart made I think, and the black border is not just wasted space. And let me just remove the plastic because it's kind of annoying to look at, because it has some kind of rainbow effect. So here we see the phone without the plastic now. And in the top we find the light and proximity sensor, the ear speaker and front facing camera. We see there is also a black border in the top, but this, the borders in the side, the bezels are kind of thin. We find here something that looks like two speakers, but could be just part of the design. Actually we have a small hole placed in this location, and I believe this will be the microphone hole. And here we see the micro USB port and some screws. The frame here is made of real metal, so it's kind of heavy actually. We have the SIM trays, dual SIM trays. I believe it supports micro and nano. In the top we find the 3.5 mm headphone jack. On this side we have the power button together with the volume rocker. And they are a little bit loose.
must admit, when I do like this, I can feel they move a little bit, but could be okay. Notice also we have this CNC made frame, so it's white in the center but silver in the edges. Looks pretty nice. On the back we find the rear camera together with the LED flash. This is a single LED. We have the Qbot logo and a CE logo and the website. So the back side here is just made of matte plastic. And in my opinion, it's okay, but does feel a little bit cheap. Doesn't feel that premium. The phone looks very premium at first sight, but the backside, yeah, I don't really like how it feels. But okay, for the price, I guess it's fine. And let me do a 360 degree of the phone.
At first sight, it could almost look a bit similar to the Xiaomi Mi Note or Letty V S1.
So just to compare the size, let me show you another phone similar design. This is the Letty V S1. Also black and white design. You can see the Qbot is a little bit bigger, but still very stylish to look at. And in fact the thickness is thinner on the Qbot. And here you can see the bezels, about the same thickness I would say. Only the bottom bezel is thicker on the Qbot, but as told it's used for the capacitive buttons. Okay, so here you see the phone for the first time, and from stock it comes with a black wallpaper. Let me just try to change the wallpaper so we can see how it looks. Let's try this one here. And you can see the display is pretty sharp, full HD, seems to have pretty good colors, and right now the brightness is not set to the highest. You can see it's set really low. Let's just try to turn it up. And you can see very, very bright. Turn it down again. Okay. And we also find the app drawer, some pre-installed apps. So not too much bloatware pre-installed, seems to be fine. And as told, we have the home button here, the back key, and also the menu key. Let's just check in the settings and let's see in about. So let me just show you the build number. Android version 5.1. Wireless update is supported. Let's check here in the top the auto rotation animation. Yeah, so this is true 5.1. We have directly access to the Wi-Fi. So far it looks really nice. Let's have a quick look inside the camera app. So this one looks to be stock. It has support for picture in picture. Let's see here in the settings. Also standard settings, nothing fancy. And we find 16 megapixels. UI seems fast and smooth. So that was just a very quick unboxing and overview of the phone. I will of course soon bring a full review of this device. I I'm going to test out this device for some days. So please stay tuned on my channel. If you have any questions, please comment below, give a thumbs up. Thank you for watching, and I'll see you in the next one.